All right, so as you can see on the screen, that's who I am. You can also see me on the video. So I am a Microsoft certified trainer, and it's been good, I would say almost 7 years that I have been associated in the domain of training and development, wherein I have been delivering various kinds of sessions across the globe related to both the technical and the non-technical skills. So my current expertise and forte lies in the domain of power platform and artificial intelligence. So I hold all the necessary certifications that are applicable for power platform, all the way starting from PL900 till PL600. And along with that, I also take certain sessions on artificial intelligence on Azure platform. So sessions like, let's say, courses on AI 900, AI 102 are also something that I take care of. Prior to this, I have been associated with organizations like Concentrix and Tech Mahindra for a huge tenure in my career. Wherein again, I was responsible for delivering sessions, both the technical and non-technical sessions, to both kind of audiences. So that's a brief about me. I'm currently working as a mentor and a senior trainer here at Koenig Solutions. And if you also have my contact details on the screen, so in case if you would want to reach out, please feel free to do that. So that's a brief about me, guys. Now, I do see we have a huge amount of participation over here in the session. So it would not really be feasible to ask everyone about, their introduction. That might just take up a little over than an hour entirely. That is what the session is all about. So I would request all of you to please drop a brief introduction about yourself in the chat window. That will be really helpful. Along with that, it would be really great if you guys could also put in a brief about whether you have any experience with Power Platform or if you have worked with Chat GPT as well. So that will give me some clarity about whether we have, people who are getting to know about the concept for the first time or if we have people who have worked with us. Okay, so we're going to wait for a couple of minutes while you guys are putting down the introductions, and I will be able to go through them as and when we are able to go through the session. All right, we're just going to wait for a couple of minutes, guys, while you put down the introduction. Meanwhile, I will be reading through the introductions as well. So please feel free to drop those. I see people are still joining in the session. So welcome people who are still joining in. We have just started with the introductions. Don't worry, I've not missed out a lot. We will be starting with the official content in another couple of minutes. All right, we have our first message here. Thank you, Anthony. Welcome to the session. Says that we mainly work with Power BI at the moment. All right, so that means we are new to the other components of Power Platform. That's great. Working in retail domain as a senior data analyst. Thank you, Siva. Welcome to the session. If you could also help me, if you've worked with any Power Platform components, that will be great. Shubhanshu, hi, welcome to the session. Says you are working with Power Platform, MDA, and Canvas. So model-driven applications and Canvas applications. Brilliant. That will be very easy for you to understand the content then. Hi, Stefan, welcome to the session. Totally new to you. All right. You've primarily worked with C++, C#, software engineer particularly. Okay, that's good over here. So it seems like we have people from across various domains. Right. So don't worry. Once we get started with the session, you will have a fair idea about what is Power Platform and how can we get started with Power Platform using the Chat GPT. We're just going to wait for another minute over here. OK, hi, Manuel, working as Oracle DBA. All right. OK, so we have another one. Guys, I'm so sorry if I mispronounced the name by any chance. I'm really bad with names, so please forgive me if I do that and feel free to correct me. OK, so we have another one, Shoyonika. I hope I'm saying that right. Cloud Security Architect and Financial Services. Power Platform is new to you. All right, no problem. We'll give you an understanding. Hussein, hi, welcome to the session. New to Power Platform, background of C# dev, but in management role, wanting to explore more on Power BI with AI. Okay, so people who are wondering to know more about Power BI, I will be able to talk about certain courses that will cover that in detail. But here in this particular session, we will not really be talking about Power BI. So I'm extremely sorry for that. We will be just talking about the concept, but nothing about it in detail. Okay, just to give you an expectation on the session. All right, so Williams here. Hi, Kobia Williams. Welcome to the session. You're working at University of Energy and Natural Resources, Ghana. That's amazing. Great. Welcome to the session. Good to know that we have people across from across the globe. Okay, we still have people joining in. Just allow me a couple of seconds. All right. Okay. Great. So I think we have, you know, people from various parts of the globe and, you know, from various domains, various technologies. So once again, guys, welcome everyone, people who have just joined the session. My name is Damini Sabharwal, and I will be taking you through this particular course. So without waiting any further, let's get started with this journey on the session of an overview of Power Platform with ChatGPT. All right, so that's what it is all about. Now, in this particular session, we will be mainly looking at three aspects, okay? Since we have people who are new to the concept of Power Platform, I will try to give you just a conceptual understanding of what Power Platform is all about, okay? So that's what the first topic is all about. Moving on to, we will see how can we create a very simple application using ChatGPT, and then we'll also talk about creating a very simple flow using ChatGPT. Now, if the terms like Canvas application and simple flow is a little complicated, a little alien to you, don't worry, I will be able to talk about this once we get started. Okay, so without further ado, let's get started with our overview and let's see what exactly this session is all about. Now, before we move on further, I'm going to quickly share my entire screen and I will be able to take you to our whiteboard. All right, well, let's quickly do that. Oh, I see people are still adding up a lot of introductions over here. That's great. Good to see that. So with this, now because this is going to be an hour of session, we will not really be, will not really be able to talk about everything related to Power Platform, of course, right? Because the concept is huge. It's really vast. So we'll not be able to cover everything, but let's see what we will be looking at. I'm going to take you to the whiteboard over here. It's going to be 60 minutes of session, right? And in the 60 minutes of session, we'll start with an introduction to Power Platform. Now, for people who have heard about Power Platform, people who have been working with Power Platform, if I ask you, what do you understand about the term Power Platform? How would you answer to this? Anybody who'd like to respond to that? What do you think is the meaning of the term Power Platform? Feel free to use the chat window to put your answers, guys. I will be waiting for your answer. I'm just going to wait for a minute for you to respond and then we're going to proceed further. Anybody who'd like to answer this, what is the meaning of the term Power Platform or what is Power Platform for you? Okay, so we have Eva here. Hi, Eva. She says that it's the set of tools in Office 365 family. Brilliant. So this is basically a set of tools in the O365 family. Brilliant. What else? So we have Hassan who says that it's basically data transformation tool. All right. Let's put that as well. It's a data transformation tool. It definitely has data transformation tools. So brilliant, the answer. Shubhanshu says it's a cloud-based business solutions based on CDS. Brilliant. Thank you so much, Shubhanshu. So yes, it is indeed a cloud platform. Let's try to understand what exactly is Power Platform. Now, Power Platform is actually based on a concept which allows you to create custom business solutions for your organization, okay? So if I talk about Power Platform, it's actually a group of SaaS. When I say SaaS, software as a service, which allows you to create business solutions. Right? So which means using Power Platform, we are able to create any kind of solution for our organization based on the current requirement. Now, the term may seem a little vague. What do you mean by business solutions? What kind of solutions am I talking about? So we're primarily talking about four different groups of products that we can create, or four different groups of solutions that we can create using four core services of Power Platform, right? So there are four core components, which when summed up together is called as Power Platform. The first component amongst this is called Power Apps. Power Apps is basically a low-code application development environment, right? Using which we are able to create custom business applications for my organization, right? Along with that, we have Power Automate. Power Automate is a component which allows you to create automation solutions, right? Automation solutions using this particular Power Platform. Okay. Now, when I say automation solutions, think about any tasks that you may have been doing repeatedly. And think about a situation wherein you are able to automate every single thing that you do. For example, let's say I have an approval process that is followed in my organization. Whenever somebody, you know, creates a request, it first has to go to the approval. And once the approval comes in, it needs to check a few more conditions and then go for additional level of the approval. We can automate that entire process without you having to do anything manually. That is what Power Automate is all about. We also have Power BI. Power BI used to be called as Microsoft BI. It's a tool which allows you to do powerful data transformations, which allows you to analyze your data. This is what we call as the analytical leg of Power Platform, which allows you to analyze the data to get any sort of insights from your data, right? And we are able to use multiple visualization options using which we are able to create reports and dashboards. Now, for people who are wondering what kind of visualizations are we talking about, go back and think about all of those times when you have to present any kind of data and you use various kinds of charts, let's say pie charts, line charts, column charts, bar graphs, histograms. These are all the visualizations that you may be using in order to create interactive reports. That's what we can do with Power BI. It's a talk of the town, honestly. Then we have the fourth component, but not the least, which is called as Power Virtual Agents. The term might give you some idea, but just to clarify, this is a tool which allows you to create custom chatbot solutions, right? Which means I am able to create a custom chatbot solution all by myself without having to write even a single line of code. So all those times when you sit down and think that what if I could create a chatbot for my organization, now you can do it by yourself. And that too without needing any knowledge or any experience in development or programming languages. So these are the four core components that Power Platform has to offer. There's one more that is recently added, but we're not going to talk about that right now. We're just going to leave it as it is. Okay, so these are the four core components that are also updated over here. What is Power Platform? It's a low-code platform that spans across Office 365, Azure, Dynamics, group of products, and the standalone applications, right? There's Power Apps, Power Automate, Power Virtual Agent, and Power BI. Now, along with that, we have some supporting components as well, which helps in the creation of these applications and these automation solutions and so forth. Right. If I talk about any component to begin with, regardless an application or an automation solution, the core behind that will be to the data to work with. Right. Which brings me to the first supporting component over here called Dataverse. It is basically the in-house database. Right. It is an in-house database for the Power Platform services, using which I can cater all the data requirements that I will have while working with my applications, with my automation solutions, and anything else for that matter, right? But it is actually a tabular relational database. People who have been working with databases, they would understand what is the meaning of a relational database, right? A tabular database where the data is stored in the structure of rows and columns, right? But what if my data is not in Dataverse? What if my data lives in SharePoint? Or for that matter, my data comes from Azure Cloud or maybe SQL Server. How do I get the data from there? In that situation, we have hundreds of data connectors to connect with in order to create an end-to-end solution. Right. We also have AI Builder. Now, AI Builder is a capability which allows you to be able to add the artificial intelligence capabilities into your applications and to your flows, to your automation solutions, right? So think about a solution which can make your created application or the created automation solution intelligent with the AI capabilities infused to it. This is what AI Builder can do for you, right? Now, what kind of capabilities do we have? What all we can do for this? What kind of applications that we can create? We're not really be talking about that right now. right? The session is not only about Power Platform, but rather a little bit more around that, right? So in case if you're interested to know more about these components and how to create all of those, we have a course available called PL900, okay? It is a fundamental level course for anybody who has no idea about Power Platform. They can go through this 8 hours of course in order to understand the basics of all of these components and create solutions all by yourself, right? So I'll share some links around this towards the end in case if you are interested about this further, right? Now, I hope that we are clear with the concept of Power Platform for people who are new and people who have heard about the concept. I hope it is clear to everyone. May I please get a confirmation if it's all clear, guys? Just a thumbs up would work. Great. Thank you, Sebastian. I hope it's clear for others as well. Great. Thank you for responding, guys. Really appreciate that. All right. So with this, let's move on further. And now let's move on to the concept of Chat GPT, right? Now, for people who have or who may not have heard about Chat GPT, I would want to ask it from you, what is your understanding of the term Chat GPT? What do you understand from this particular term? What is Chat GPT as per you? Let's go over here and let's put it over here. Have you heard about Chat GPT? Yes or no? Or maybe if you have heard about it, what do you know about this? It's been the talk of the town recently. There are a lot of people who are trying to, you know, work with Chat GPT, understand what this is all about. Okay. So people who are agreeing to, you know, to having the knowledge about this, what is Chat GPT as for you? What do you know about this? Feel free to use the chat window and put your thoughts in the comments. Okay, so Marcus says it's an AI chatbot which is used to create code snippets and answer questions. Brilliant. Thank you, Marcus. So it's an AI chatbot. Brilliant, yes. Used to get answers to our questions. Rightly mentioned. Thank you, Marcus. Hassan says it is basically working on the pre-trained AI models. That is absolutely correct. It is indeed. Okay, another answer says it's an AI chatbot built by OpenAI. Brilliant. Thank you for answering this. It is built by OpenAI, right? So what exactly is ChatGPT? Let's talk about this as a concept, right? Now, people who have answered, they've brilliantly answered it. It is basically an AI-enabled chatbot, right, which is developed by OpenAI. And it's a pretty new thing that has hit the market. It, I believe, launched in the month of, November 2022, if I'm not wrong. Now, this particular chatbot is basically enabled with the GPT capabilities. What exactly is GPT? If I take you to the slide, it says it's chat generative pre-trained transformer. Okay, what exactly it is? It is developed by OpenAI and was launched in November 2022. It's such a tool which has the capability of answering your queries in a conversational tone, in a manner the way that human beings communicate with one another, right? So that means it has the capabilities of natural language understanding, using which they are able to give you the answers of the question that you may not know the answers of. When you have a question, you're stuck anywhere, you're getting an error, you want to write certain snippet of code. If you have any such issues, feel free to turn to ChatGPT and it will be able to give you the answers to your questions. So let's get started and let's see how do we interact with this ChatGPT. For that, what we will do is I will quickly go back to my browser and I'm going to open ChatGPT interface that can be accessed by using this URL, chat.openai.com. Okay, this is the interface that will open up. I am already logged into the portal. Okay, in case if you are new to this particular portal, feel free to register yourself first. It will be asking you to register first, right? And once you register, just provide your details. It will be able to give you free access to connect with the service, right? So I'm going to share this link with you in the chat for people who are new to ChatGPT. Let's put this over here. Okay, my team seems to be stuck. There we go. This is ChatGPT portal. There we go. Now, once we are through with this, let's see how do we work with this. Now, for people who are new to Power Platform, who has no idea about Power Platform, if you want to learn more about Power Platform, ChatGPT can also answer questions based on that. For example, if I ask a basic question, like let's say, what is Power Platform? It will be able to curate an answer and give me that understanding. So Power Platform is a low-code platform developed by Microsoft that enables users to create business applications, automated workflows, analyze the data. It has Power BI, Power Apps, Power Automate, and we spoke about Power Virtual Agent as well. Right? Together, these tools provide a comprehensive suite of services for business to build custom solutions. Right? Similarly, let's say if I start with what are the types of Power Apps? So there are three mainly, I would say now there are two, but initially there used to be three kinds of Power Apps. Okay, so let's see what this says. It also recognizes that there are three types of Power Apps. Okay, the reason why I'm saying there are two now, because one of the component has been removed under the bracket of Power Apps and is now introduced as an individual component. Okay, so you can see we have three different kinds of applications. We have Canvas application, we have model driven application, and then we have portals. Okay, portals are now renamed as Power Pages, which is like an individual component. Okay, so here we have Canvas and model driven application. Now, when I talk about Canvas application, it says that it allows you to design custom user interfaces that allows user to interact with the data from multiple sources. Okay, so think about a situation wherein you want to create an application. All right, now when you want to create an application, you have a particular UI in mind, right? Basically, an interface that you want to design. Let's say if I start with this interface, there we go. So let's say this is the screen, and now I want to create an application. So I would most likely be able to think about, or let's say imagine about this application on a screen by screen level, right? Wherein I would think that maybe if I want to create a new application that will be able to, let's say, allow my new hires to update their personal information in the database. Okay, so for example, when you join the company, you have information about, let's say, your profile details, your experience details. Maybe you also have information about your educational qualifications that you will have to provide to the company, right? Let's say you're creating an application to update all of that. So this app is supposed to be interacted by the new hires of the company. Okay, so what you think about, you would think about, let's say, the logo of the application of the company, and maybe the name of the company would appear over here, right? Maybe here I would want to show a map which can show the global presence of my organization to the new hires. Maybe here I would want to highlight, the who's who of the company, basically a tree map of the company, right? Showing, let's say, the senior managers, the associate directors, and let's say the CEOs and CFOs, this kind of information. So that my user, my new hire can understand who are the top notches of the, or are the top shots of the company, right? Maybe here I want to have a plus icon. When the user clicks on the plus icon, they should be treated with a new screen wherein they can provide their information, their name, address, phone number, whatever that we want to capture. So what are we doing? We are basically defining the layout based on which I want to move on further. Okay, keeping this UI in mind, I can start with a Canvas application. Okay, Canvas application is a highly customizable application, right? Wherein I can design the UI, basically the layout of my application from the scratch based on my requirements, right? Moving on further, we also have another benefit of working with Canvas application, and that is that it can connect with multiple data sources, right? So I would not really be required to put my data in my Dataverse necessarily, at Power Platform database. We don't really need to do that. If I have my data in, let's say, SharePoint, if I have my data anywhere else, I will be able to use that data in order to create my application. Okay, we have few other kinds of applications as well. For example, we have a model-driven application, which is not a highly customizable application, right? Here we have less customizable options. Right, that's a less customizable app, wherein the layout is defined by Power BI. Okay, sorry, Power Apps, my bad, by Power Apps. Along with that, here it can only connect with only connect with dataverse data, right? So these are the main differences between the two kinds of applications that we have. Excuse me. Now, over here, with both of these kinds of applications, we will currently be looking at a Canvas application. Okay, so let's say I want to create an application that will look something like this. I want to create an application based on a table called contacts. Okay, wherein I want to update the records in this contact table. So I want to have an interface wherein the users can read the content, can read the records from the contact table. Right, and along with that, I also want to allow my users that they can also, let's say, update, they can review the details as well. Review the details about a selected record. Okay, so let's start with this. Let's see how can we create an application. But let's say I am somebody who doesn't know anything about Power Apps. So what do? I go to ChatGPT. It can give me the answer. So let's say, how to create a Canvas app using contact table as a data source, right? And let's say this contact table is currently available in my Power Apps. So I'm going to show to Power Apps first of all. Let's open Power Apps. From here, I have a list of tables. Okay. Now from these tables here, I will be able to find all the list of tables which are available in my Dataverse. And amongst all of this, I have one of the table called as contacts. Okay. So let's say I'm going to go to my contact table. Now, here you can see I have certain columns, I have forms, and a lot of other details which are already available within this particular table. Along with that, it also has a lot of data over here as well, some sample data that we can work with. Okay, so let's just wait while this interface loads up and then I'll show you the output. All right. So here you can see I have my full name column, I have a lot of other columns over here, and then I have column values over here, right? And here I can see the sample data that is available, right? If you want to, I can either update the values over here or I can also do that from my application. So that's what we will learn how to work with. Now over here, when I ask how to create a Canvas application based on contact table as a data source, so it says to create a Canvas application using contact table, open the Canvas App Studio and start from Canvas App from blank. Select your phone or tablet size. Let's start to follow the steps one by one. Now, one thing which is a little on the downside for this particular interface is because it might still use few of the terminologies which are not really updated, right? So because this is again working on certain models which were trained in the past. So there is a possibility that the new technologies or the new terminologies may be something that might just be alien to ChatGPT. Okay, so it's just going to work, you know, as and when you're able to work with that, the better it will be able to get on further, right? So let's say I'm going to start with this. It says open the studio and start Canvas from blank template. So I'm going to start over here. Let's go to our apps. And I will be able to start with a blank application. New app. I'll start with Canvas. And let's call it Chat GPT. Contacts app. I'm going to select the layout as the phone layout. I'm not really going to go for a tablet, okay? But you will have to select this layout, and it's something which cannot be changed later. It will define what kind of structure your users will be able to interact with, whether you want to create a phone screen application or tablet screen. Let's start with create. Let's keep it on a different screen so that we'll be able to toggle easily, right? It will be able to come back over here. So for now, there we go. For now, let's go back to our apps. It's just launching that blank application template for us. So let's start with that. Okay. We'll try to follow the steps. And in case if we are stuck anywhere, we're going to ask some clarifying questions from our bot. Let's see how it will respond to that. Okay, that seems to be taking some time. Maybe I'll open this over here. Oh, that does seem to be taking some time. So sorry for that, guys. So meanwhile, while this is opening up, let me ask this. If you have any questions over here, let's check in the chat as well. No more questions. Guys, if you have any questions, feel free to use the chat window to ask your questions, okay? While this is opening, we'll be able to, you know, answer the questions as well. I feel that there's some updates that might just be going in the back end due to which, you know, it's causing some delays. Oh, there we go. It's launching now. We can see the app name over here at the top. Getting things ready. So for people who are interacting with this interface for the first time, just to give you some clarity, this is the interface where we create our application. That's what we call as Power Apps Canvas Studio. Okay, so now we are here. What we will do is we'll go back to our interface that we were creating, and let's start from here. We selected the site. Now here it says, click on data and select your data source. Okay, we'll do that. Let's go to our data. And this is my data option. I'll go over here. I'll click on add data, and this is my contact table. I'll be using that over here. Okay. Once this is added, what is the next step that it's asking us to do? Let's go and look at that. It says, from here, you have selected and clicked on connect. Now you need to add a gallery control onto your screen, right? So I need to basically add a gallery onto my particular screen. So in order to add a gallery, what I will do is I'll simply go back to my Power Apps. Let's say I would want multiple screens as well. So here I'll go to add a new screen. Under the screen, I have an option of list over here. This is what can be added as a gallery. Okay, so it's basically a collection of multiple rows that I will be able to see from my data table. Okay. Now let's try and look at that. Oh, we still have people joining in. There we go. All right, so this is my application. You can see I have this collection of records. Now, what I want to do is I want to associate this with my contact table. So what I'll do is I will simply select my gallery, right, this collection of records. I'll select my data source, and I will be able to update this data source accordingly. Okay, so my data source needs to be coming from my, let's say, from my contact table. So we'll be able to go ahead and modify that as well. As of now, you can see it's coming from some sample data. Right. So rather than updating this data from sample, I will be able to update this from my contact table. Right. But maybe this is not something that really adds a lot of value to me. So what I can do is this is something which is basically confusing. So I'll just click on one of the row and it will allow me to add the contact table over here. So here, if you notice, I have updated this step wherein I chose a table, I added my contact table and I clicked on connect. Right, my gallery control is now showing me the contacts. Right, now what it says is select the gallery control and then click on items and choose the contact data source. I've updated that. Right, now I can update my values and it can show me the exact contacts that we are looking for. Let's see if I go back. It's now blank as of now, no problem. It's just updating over here. You can see it's buffering. There we go. I can see my contacts. If I click on play over here, it will be able to show me the records coming from my contact table. Okay. Now, what I want to do is I want to have another screen wherein I can review the details about a particular contact as well. So what I can do is I will go and ask my ChatGPT. I'll ask my ChatGPT, hey ChatGPT, tell me how to add a screen to view the details about the selected contact from the gallery. Let's start with this. It says to add a screen to view the details, what you need to do is you need to go to the studio and select the screen which contains the gallery screen, and you need to add a duplicate screen over here. It will create a copy, right? And you can rename it to something like contact details, right? From there, you will remove the gallery control and then you will be able to add a form control on that. Okay. And then we will be able to add the details. So let's try and add that over here. See, it's giving me the entire details. I don't have to do anything manually. This is the interface which is allowing me to do all of that by myself. Okay. The entire steps all the way up till the end. Okay. So let's try and follow these steps now. So what I will do is I will go back. Let's duplicate the screen. That's what it asked me to do. Let's say I am over here. What I will do is I'll select my gallery over here. You can see I will select my gallery from here. It will select my entire gallery. See, only the gallery. I'll just simply hit the delete key to delete that. Now I have a blank screen. And from here, what it says is, see, I have duplicated the screen. Now I will be able to, I've deleted the gallery. Now I'll add a form control over here. Okay. And the form control will have the data source as contact table. Okay. And over here, it is giving me the reference that I would need to provide as well. So what I will do is I'll simply go back to my Power Apps. And over here, I will add a form. So which form? Let's say I'm going to go with my edit form. Now I have my edit form. Let's start with this over here. Okay. And in the data source, I will be able to submit my contact details. Now, what else it's asking me to do? It's saying once you've added the source as contact table, in the right-hand side, set the item property of the form control to this formula. Let's add that. Assuming, you can see, assuming your gallery control is named as gallery one. We have not made any changes to the gallery, so let's see if it is going to work. Let's check that. So I have, let's edit some fields from here. You can see I have full name. Let's say I'm going to remove full name. I don't want to look at full name. I will be looking at first name. And I will be looking at last name. Select and add. There we go. Right. Now, what it's saying is in the gallery control, we'll go to the item property and I will be able to update the formula that they have provided. Okay, I will get rid of this entirely. We'll get rid of this as well. And this is my gallery one selected. Let's see what is the control name that we have. I have the gallery name as browse gallery one. So let's rename this to browse gallery. Browse gallery one, that's selected. Okay, and you can see the moment I do that, it's automatically showing me the values. Let's go back to our screen and let's see if it is working for all the values. We'll click on selected. I will click on, let's say, this is the value that I want to show, but I don't have any space wherein I can click and I can select this one. Okay, now I don't have a way if I, let's say, click on any particular record, if I click on this one, right, or if I, let's say, select on this one, I need to have a particular way through which it can go to the other screen. As of now, it's by default showing me the value for the currently selected records. Right, you can see we selected day one and showing me the data for you one over here. Okay, but it needs to navigate to that screen as well for me to be able to show that selected value. Okay, for this, let's say we're going to go with another function because it is not really giving me the output value. Let's read further. It says, customize your form control by adding the arranging fields. Select the button on the right-hand side and on the on select, use this particular formula. Okay, you need to select the button, which button? On the original screen. Okay, on the original screen, I need to have this particular button on which I can assign the value. Instead of adding a new button, what I will do is I'll assign the property to this arrow button. Okay, so I'll select this arrow button and for the on select property again, I will go and update this value. Right, contact details, is this the one that we are looking at? I don't want to go to contact details. Okay, contact details is basically what it understood, what it asked me to give a name to the screen. Right, I have not renamed the screen, so let's go ahead and rename the screen over here. Rename. Contact details. Now let's go back over here, original screen. Let's select this arrow and my contact details. This is the screen that we are looking at, right? We'll remove the last option. There we go. Let's save it and let's test it. See, the moment I click here, it is able to show me the values. Right, so that is how what we did is we were able to create an application that could show me the records. Of course, now I can update some values over here, right? I can maybe add the name called as contacts over here. This is going to be the name of the application maybe, right? And I can select whichever record that I'm talking about. Let's say if I click on Maria Campbell, let's go and select this. Maria Campbell. I'll click on the arrow and it will show me the details for Maria Campbell. This is what is happening based on the instructions provided by ChatGPT. I did not do anything manually. ChatGPT was able to help me with this. Okay. Now, this is a very basic structure, but you can see it is still able to give me the entire expressions as well, that if I follow the instructions to the T, these expressions would also work. But if I have different names to, let's say, the data source or let's say the control names, then I would have to modify that accordingly, what we did for Galaxy name. Right? That's a basic structure for creating applications. Similarly, this is also a powerful tool. So let's say I move on and now I look at Power Automate. We discussed Power Automate is also a very powerful tool that allows me to do automations, right? So let's ask, what is Power Automate now? I'll just close this application for now. And simultaneously, I'll open the interface for Power Automate. I'll go back from here. Now you can see, what is Power Automate? It gives me the clarity. Power Automate, formerly known as Microsoft Flow, is a cloud-based service that allows user to create workflows, automate tasks. With Power Automate, you can create workflows, right? So it gives me an entire understanding about what is Power Automate and what it can do for me. Okay, let's talk about what is a flow in Power Automate. Okay. We said Power Automate, or formerly known as Microsoft Flow, which allows you to create automation solutions. Now, there is a concept called flow in Power Automate. What is that? So if I ask the question, it says, a flow is basically a series of steps that automate a specific task. So if I talk about any automation solution that we are creating, right? Any automation solution that you're trying to create, that will be called as flow in Power Automate. Right, so it gives me the answer that's a series of steps that automates a specific task or process. How can it be triggered? What are the various components that it has available? It will give you a detailed theory on that. Okay, let's ask, what are the various types of flows? Here you can see in our Power Automate, there are several types of flow, including Power Automate, button flows, schedule flows. So these are various kinds of flows that we have, right? Automated flows are those flows which are triggered automatically based on a specific event or condition. Button flows are those flows which are triggered manually by users. Schedule flows are those flows which are triggered on a specific date or time. When I say triggered, I'm talking about when the flow will be invoked, when the flow will start. That's what I'm talking about over here. So over here, what we will do is, let's start with creating an automated flow. Okay, let's say, we'll save it. I'll go to Power Automate and I will be starting with one of the flows that we have. Okay, before that, let me explain the situation. Say, for the Power Automate, I have a situation wherein I have a SharePoint list. Okay, the SharePoint list is known by the name of, let's say, leave details, okay, or leave requests. Okay, so this table holds the information about what all requests will be submitted by the employees. Okay, what I want to do is, every time a leave request is submitted over here in this particular table, I want to initiate an approval process. Okay, once the approval process is completed, based on the outcome, it should be able to update the status of the leave request in the SharePoint. Okay, let's talk about this. So I'm going to open SharePoint as well simultaneously. Now, if I show you, let's go to ChatGPT. This is my site. And over here, I have my site content. In the site content, I have this leave request. Okay, now you can see I have one of the leaves that is updated. Let's say if I create a new leave over here called as, let's say, travel leave. Okay, the approval status will, let's say, will by default keep it to new for now. This is for traveling to, let's say, Bangalore. or let's say traveling to Berlin. Let's change it. Who is a requester? Let's say I'm going to update the requester's name as my name. We'll update the start date for the leave request as, let's say, it's not showing up the value. So let's copy this value. Right. And we'll update the end date as the same. Okay. So once this is updated, it is submitted now. Right. We'll exit the grid view. It will be able to save the request over here. Now you can see a new travel leave has been updated over here. Now, guys, I hope I'm audible to everyone. I know people are saying they're not able to hear me. Can you hear me? Sounds fine to you. Okay, all right. Okay, great, great, great. All right, thank you for confirming, guys. All right, so I have updated this travel leave request. Now, what I want to do is, the moment this request is submitted, okay, I want to, first of all, initiate an approval process, and I want to change the status to pending. And then based on the approval, I want to change it to either approved or rejected. So let's try to ask ChatGPT if it can help us with the answer. Okay, so let's say we'll go to ChatGPT and I'll say, create a flow based on the following condition. Guys, one thing to keep in mind whenever you will be working with ChatGPT, it is important that you elaborate your requirement to the maximum so that it can understand, right? It's still learning, it's still understanding. So it is important that you are able to explain and elaborate your concern so that it can give you the output, okay? Let's say the first point is I want to start an approval request when new record is added in the SharePoint list called, what is the name of our list? It's called leave request. Right, that's our first requirement. The second requirement is the moment the approval process starts, I want to update the value for this particular column to pending. Okay, so let's go and update it to update the value for the column. Which column it is? Approval status. Approval status to pending. Right, and then wait, we have started it just a little quickly. Let's add one more over here. Stop generating. The third point will be update the value for the column approval status to approved or rejected based on the outcome of the approval. Right? That's what we need. So we will update. So it says, sure, there are other steps that you require in Power Automate. First of all, you create, click on create from the automated cloud flow. Okay, we'll give the name to the flow and it defines the trigger action as a SharePoint. Let's start doing this simultaneously. So I'll go to Power Automate, we'll go to create. And it needs me to create an automated flow, right? By the name of leave request approval flow. Let's start with this one. Automated cloud flow, we'll use this. I'll give a name, right? Now, what is the other component? It also tells me the trigger is going to be SharePoint when an item is created or modified. So let's use as a trigger point. We'll look for the trigger and we need to pick up this value from SharePoint. Okay, so this is my SharePoint when an item is created or modified, create. Right now, once this is updated, choose the SharePoint site, select the leave request list, and then we'll update the conditions further. So we'll update that for now. Let's just move on further. You can see I have my SharePoint list added. Here I will start my site address. This is my site address. This is my listening. Right? So whenever this is updated, what do I want to do? I need to add the next step. The next step says, in the condition section, add a condition to check if the approval column is blank. This will ensure that only it is starting for the selected records. Let's say I don't want to add this condition for now. Okay. Now here it says, add an update item if the approval column is equal to set the approval column to pending. So let's add this update item over here. What this step will do is, it will be able to set my this column value to pending as soon as my flow has started. So let's update that. Update item in SharePoint. Which item we're going to select our SharePoint list. Let's update the list name and the ID. Now the ID is going to be coming from the dynamic content. Dynamic content is basically the output values from my previous step. So I'll use the ID field. This is basically the ID for the record that is generated. The title is going to come from my title, right? And the status is going to be changed from new to pending. Right? Now what it says is, further, once I've updated this, then I want to update the approval section. I want to start an approval or wait for an approval. Okay, for now, I'm going to tweak this a little bit. Maybe I've not defined my statement properly. That is why it's saying wait for an approval. I want to start and wait for an approval. So I'll make some minor changes to the flow over here that you will also have to do depending on if you have explained your process completely. Right? What was my requirement? My requirement said that once the approval process is, once the leave request is updated, I want to start the approval process and then update it based on the outcome. Right? So I'll go with the approval. I will start and wait for an approval rather than wait for an approval only. We'll update the approval type over here. First to respond. Has the chatbot provided me that option as well? Once the approval is completed, now you can see it is not giving me clarity on that. So this is something that you can, of course, further ask, and ChatGPT will be able to give me the answer. Then it says that you can add a condition and post that. In the yes of the condition, you can update saying it approved, and in the no section, you can say it is rejected. So we'll update this as well. I'll start with the approval. We'll update the approval name to, let's say, title, assigned to, let's say, a particular person. Right? And here I can say approval request. Or let's leave it blank. I really don't require this. Now, once this is received, based on the outcome, I want to apply a condition. So it says you can add the condition control to update this to. In the yes of the condition, you will update the approved section, and then no, you'll update the rejected one. Okay, let's add the condition control. If the outcome of my approval, right, the outcome of my approval is equal to approve, then what I will do, I will update the item saying that this is approved. SharePoint. Let's go with update item. I'll select the value, ChatGPT, list value, leave request. ID is going to be ID, and title is going to be, let's say, title is going to be coming from your title, and the status will be changed to. Similarly, I can also structure the one for the other one as well. Let's save it. I have an error. Let's see what is the error over here. Okay, the flow is ready to go. Let's see what is the error. Update item. This may result in an infinite loop. Please check you update the condition accordingly. Okay, no problem. That's okay. We will really not be required to modify this for now. So we can just skip it for now. Let's save it. And now what I will do is I'll add a new request over here. Okay. So for this, we'll edit and in the grid view. Let's add maybe new leave. Sample nominee. Done. exit and see it. Now, once this is done, you can see a new lead that is updated, and it will be able to trigger our flow as well. Right. So what we were able to do is we were able to basically create an entire flow based on the Chat GPT instructions over here. Right. So that's a brief introduction about what is Chat GPT. Right. It basically works on the NLP model. Right. It can be used to create chatbots, content creation, language translation, and can be used in various domains as well. Right. We saw there are some potential issues as well. It cannot provide issues to answers to current affairs. It may not be trained on the upcoming challenges as well. Right. We saw how do we create an application out of it. And we also saw how do we create a flow out of this as well. Right. So that's a brief about working with applications and automations using Chat GPT. Okay, so that's a brief about how do we get started. Now, in case if you're interested to know more about the concepts, you're interested to know more about how to work with other Power Platform components, then I will be putting down the links about the Power Apps and Power Platform trainings that you can review and know more about this. Right. I'll also put down the link for Koenig Solutions website, our website, wherein you can look for a variety of other trainings as well. Okay, so I'm going to put that link for you. So this is the website that we have, koenigsolutions.com. On this website, you can look for various Power Platform related courses. For example, we spoke about PL900, right? So when you go to PL900, it will be able to give you the search results. This is the one. And this will give you a detail about everything that you need to know about this particular course, right? It's an 8-hour of course that you can go through. You can review what all content will be covered and so forth. So let me drop this link in the chat for you.
Sorry to interrupt you, Damini. Before our participants leaves this meeting, I would like to inform that I have put in a link for feedback form. Please make sure that everyone fills in and acknowledge on chat. And if you have any doubt, please put your questions on chat and don't leave this meeting without filling the feedback form. I'm resharing the link again separately here. Yeah, that's very important because that's how you will get your participation certificate. Sorry, Damini, please continue.
Thank you. So guys, that was a brief about everything related to Power Apps and Power Automate. We saw how do we create an application and a flow using the instructions provided by ChatGPT. The crux of the session is basically just to ensure that you should not be stopped from learning something new. If you don't know the answer to a question, we have a brilliant new solution available called ChatGPT that will be able to give you the answers to whatever that you need to know. All right. So with this, thank you so much for your time, guys. That was it about the session. Please feel free to, submit your feedback about the session. That's absolutely important for you to, get your attendance marked for the session. And I'll hopefully see you guys again in a different session. Have a great rest of the evening, guys, and happy learning with Power Platform. Bye-bye.
Hi, everyone. Have you filled in the feedback form? Please confirm on chat. I'm resharing the feedback link again. Also, we have a webinar on 30th of March. I've already shared the registration link. I'm resharing it again. This is the link for feedback form. And the webinar, which is on 30th, its title is Automating Data Management Excel Spreadsheet Manipulation with Python. I'm resharing its registration link and the webinar title. It's on 30th of March. Once you enroll, you will get to know the timing, date and timing, everything. But still, I would like to share its timings one. It's 7 p.m. IST on 30th of March. Thank you, Meer Akbar, for confirming. Thank you, Moji Sola, for confirming. Others, please fill in the feedback and also join the course, or if you want to know more about the sources, please fill in those details in feedback so that it would be easy to connect with you for further assistance. Also, there is a link for all our upcoming webinars. It's here. You can check all our upcoming webinars, whichever is suitable for you. You can enroll for that. Also, you can share with your friends and colleagues. This is the link for all our upcoming webinars. And, we have our official Koenig LinkedIn page. You will get all our, new updates over there, whether it's webinar, whether it's our new course, whether anything related to Koenig and IT training. I'm sharing the Koenig's LinkedIn page link here. You can follow this. I'm resharing it again. You might get confused with many links, so I'll specify which link is for what. So thank you, Isana. Thank you so much for confirming. Thank you, Kumar. Thank you, Olaide. Thank you, Jose. Thank you, Ed. Thank you, John. Thank you, Meer. And I apologize if I'm not pronouncing your name properly. That's my Indian accent. Thank you, Anuver. Others, please confirm if you're done with the feedback form, because that's your attendance mark for today. If you get this participation certificate, you can add it in your resume. It would be helpful for your further career. You can mention it wherever you want. And ChatGPT is the burning topic, as you all know. It's gonna, really helpful for you all. Link is already provided to Koenig's LinkedIn page. I'm resharing it again. You can follow us for more details, more updates. Whichever webinars, we schedule for next month or next week, all those webinars are listed under our events on our Koenig's LinkedIn page. You will get a clear idea. You can check it there. And also, we have a webinar on 30th of March at 7 p.m. IST. The topic is Automating Data Management, Excel Spreadsheet Manipulation with Python. I'm resharing its registration link once again so that you will not miss it in the chat. Thank you, Siddiqui. Thank you, Ed. Thank you, Anthony. Thank you, Sharif. Here is the link. Thank you, Boitumelo. And please make sure that, thank you, Ganizo. You will write appropriate name of yours so that it will, it will appear on your certificate. And also a valid email ID so that you will get those details in your inbox, because your name and email ID will get used to distribute your certificates. This is the registration link for 30th March webinar. And there are many exciting webinars coming up. If you have any doubt, please drop your questions on chat. And if you're done with the feedback form, please confirm once. Please acknowledge. Thank you, Crystal. Okay. So, Crystal, check all our upcoming webinars. And you can, find whichever webinar is suitable for you and enroll yourself. Kumar, if you have filled in the feedback, you will get the link within 24 hours. Because once I gather the data, I'll upload it on LED panel. So take some time, let others fill in the feedback, and you will get the LED panel link and credentials to download your certificate. Thank you, Asan. Thanks for joining. Ivan Rituja, please fill in the feedback and add your email ID over there. I'll collect the data from there. Thank you, Manuel. Thank you for confirming. It was a great session. Thanks a lot for joining. And thank you for being such a patient audience for, scrolling so many links. And have a great day ahead and keep joining our upcoming webinars. Thank you so much.